What's up, guys? My name is Kel, and welcome to my new series on Final Fantasy XV. So, I have been playing this game for the last couple days. This is not a 100% blind playthrough. I've played about 6 hours. I've finished the first chapter, working through my second chapter, and I figured, you know what, it's time to start a series on it. I actually am loving this game. It's going to suck up so much of my time, and I haven't played a game that has engrossed me so much since probably a Souls game. So, since Dark Souls 3. I mean, that's not too long ago, but it's been a while since a new sort of game, because the last couple Final Fantasies really haven't pulled me in like this one has. Anyway, new game, let's do it. There are a lot of load screens on this. Don't worry, I will be cutting them out so you don't have to sit through the fucking load screens. We're going to play... going to be playing on normal, and we are not going to do the tutorial, because it's just, I'll talk about game mechanics as we go. Final Fantasy XV, in a time unknown, only a prophecy keeps alive in people's hearts. When darkness veils the world, the King of Light shall come. Now four brave warriors begin their journey, prepared to fight. What awaits the four, however, they do not know. And as you can see, the load screen is pretty long. This is the only load screen I'm not going to cut out, because it had relevant, sort of relevant information. The Tale of the Chosen King, Savior to the Star. Noctis, Lucis, Calium, or Calum? Alright, here we go. Do this, bitch. Yeah, the game doesn't start just by talking, which is awesome. Most JRPGs start just blabbing around. It starts and you're fucking on fire.
Hang in there, buddy.
Prompto or just
stay down. We'll keep him busy.
Thanks, bro.
Not over here.
Ignis.
Quickly, before he strikes again.
Here comes
Gladius or Glodeolus.
I got your back.
Here you go. Let's go.
That is a vision of things to come, I would assume. I don't actually know yet. Before the fall. And we just got this white screen. It's pretty cool. Game looks fantastic. Though I think this is all from... No, it's not.
The decreed hour is come. Set forth with my blessing, Prince Noctis.
Thank you, Your Majesty.
Take your leave and go in the grace of the gods.
Right.
Well, princes will be princes.
So much for royal protocol.
Not like you had to deliver a formal address.
Your Highness!
What now?
I fear I have left too much unsaid. You place a great burden on those who would bear with you.
You're one to talk.
I ask not that you guide my wayward son, merely that you remain at his side.
Indeed, Your Grace.
We'll see the prince to Altissia if it's the last thing we see.
Yeah, what he said. Hate to break this up, but Kor's got the motor running. Drados, he's in your hands.
And another thing. Do mind your manners around your charming bride-to-be.
Your Majesty as well. Try to mind yours around our esteemed guests from Niflheim.
You have no cause for concern.
Nor do you.
Take heed. Once you set forth, you cannot turn back.
You think I would?
I need only know that you are ready to leave home behind.
Don't know about you, but I'm ready as I'll ever be.
Take care on the long road. Wheresoever you should go, the line of Lucis goes with you. Walk tall.
my son.
All right, I guess this is worth reading out. It just says, Chapter 1, Departure. Prince Noctis Lucius Calum, I don't know how to say his name, sets forth from his homeland with his three-man retinue in tow. His destination, Alticia, capital of Accordo, where he will formalize the union of states through his marriage to Lady Lunafreya of the Imperial Province of Tenebrae. So, yep, I'm going to cut it out now. Don't have to listen, or don't have to wait through this goddamn load screen.
It's like we boys are down on hard times. Our way there. Thought people were friendly outside the city.
You can only count so far on the kindness of strangers.
You're just gonna have to push her all the way.
I've already pushed myself to the brink of death.
Get
up. Drama queen.
Come on, car isn't gonna move itself.
Sheesh. I thought the car was supposed to move us.
Wouldn't that be nice?
Can it? Ready, steady.
Ready, steady, go. So heavy. Yep, I'm just gonna push this car. This is how the game starts. Good start. We totally look like we're in the American Midwest too. Got like these billboards.
Unbelievable.
Not exactly a fairy tale.
Rocky, craggy cliffs.
We let ourselves get carried away.
Look, these things happen.
Let's just hope this isn't some omen.
Gladio, do me a favor.
What?
Push this thing by yourself.
All by myself?
You won't even notice if we just let go.
Pronto, don't even think about it.
Save some breath for pushing.
Ignis, come on, time to switch.
Nuh-uh, we just switched back there.
And it's my turn, Noct.
His turn.
This dude looks like he's barely pushing.
You rather I kill you with mine?
Easy there, tough guy.
Any luck? Only a busy signal.
Hold the phone. Is it just me? Or was it supposed to be way closer?
I assure you, the map is correct.
The map said Hammerhead was right there.
Literally, next door.
Looks that way. On a map of the world.
I love the dynamic between all the characters. It feels fairly believable. I find it endearing.
The world's a big old place,
filled with wonders.
Tell that to my legs.
You guys even pushing?
Hard as I can.
Everything I've got.
There we go, Final Fantasy 15. Choice of song is a little weird too. Sweet, here we are at the Hammerhead Outpost. Getting pretty close to actual gameplay here.
Hey there, y'all kept a girl waiting.
Damn, girl.
Now, which one's the prince?
She doesn't even have her shorts pulled up all the way.
Hello,
you can still see her, like,
congrats
thong.
On your wedding.
Not hitch just yet.
Lady Lunafreya's groom-to-be, here in Hammerhead.
Apologies for taking so long.
You best save your apologies for Papa.
Well, that makes you...
Cindy. Sid's grease monkey granddaughter.
Roll her in while I'm still young. Didn't your daddy tell you? She's a custom classic, not some beat-up old clunker. Prince Noctis.
Yeah.
Prince. Like they took your old man and kicked the dignity out of him.
What?
You got a long way to go, son. And that slackjaw's getting you nowhere fast.
So it doesn't take shit.
She's gonna take a while. Y'all get her in and run along.
Y'all heard him. Let's get moving. Right this way.
I don't think Cindy could be wearing any less clothing.
Never any good at it either.
Though, you know, I'm not complaining or anything. Let's go talk to her. What's up, girl?
Y'all ain't never been out this way before, have you? Go on, have a look around. This'll make sure y'all don't get lost.
Huzzah, world map. Thank you, my dear. Visit the local tipster to gather information.
Might as well make good use of the extra time.
He'll take his time, but he'll get her done.
He'll get her done.
They got Ebony out here. Oh, Ignis is gonna flip. Wait, what's a gil?
What's a gil? That is the unit of currency in the game. Customize and service the regalia at the garage. The regalia is the name of the car. We can buy some weapons and stuff from this dude. Can't currently because we are dead ass broke. We can refill the car's gas here. Once again, dead ass broke. What's up, bro?
I got a feeling our money's no good here, Noct.
Bet you Ignis came prepared though. Let's ask him.
Enough for room and board.
Alright, let's talk to Ignis. I don't want to refuel.
A moment, Noct. We've expended the last of our funds on the repairs. I suggest we confer with Cindy.
Broken down and flat broke.
Adding insult to injury.
Alright, so our first quest is the Popper Prince. We gotta go talk to Cindy.
Old man's in for both after charging us that much.
Yeah. We can go to the diner, but let's go talk to Cindy first. Yo, girl, we may be a little broke.
She ain't gonna be ready for a while. Y'all need something?
Can we get a discount?
Bit steep for a simple tune-up, don't you think?
Oh, now I get it. This must be what Papa meant when he said he was gonna teach them boys a lesson. Told me he ought to have y'all take care of some ornery varmints that have been causing a ruckus around here. I'd be happy to pay y'all for your services if you're up to the challenge. How about it?
Well, so much for finding an easy way out. Thanks a lot, Papa.
Yeah, I got 10 AP. Spend ability points to power up Noctis. Basically, there's like skill trees. You can spend the AP on skill trees. I guess we'll do that now. Alright, let's see. Let's just boost our... Actually, you know what? I think the best ones to get early on are these. The exploration ones. I don't think we can afford any of them. No, we can't get any of them yet. Alright, let's just get some combat. Let's get... reduce the MP of phasing. Yeah, why not? Phasing is like warping around in combat. When we get to combat, I will show you that in case you don't know.
But don't go running around after dark. The demons are liable to rip y'all to shreds. Here, this ought to be enough for a place to stay. Just between us, though. Don't tell Papa.
I won't tell Papa. See if we can buy any new weapons.
Make
combat a little easier. Broadsword. Two-handed sword, war sword. Let's see attack on these bad boys. I think I should just go ahead and buy, we'll buy a war sword for Glodius.
We're doing business.
We'll buy some Avengers for Ignis. And we'll buy a better gun for Prompto. And we don't really need, I guess we do need a better, melee weapon.
Hey, come again.
A long sword or whatever. Thanks, bro. Alright, let's equip our new gear. Noctis. We'll swap the engine blade into this. Does a significantly more damage. I have the Moss Immune here, which is from the Collector's Edition DLC. Or the stuff that comes with the Collector's Edition. And then he's also got a javelin, which is fine. Let's see. Our good buddy here will equip the war sword. He will equip daggers, and you will equip a better gun. So each character can equip different things. Noctis is the main character. He's the only character you directly play, and he can equip basically every type of weapon. I'm leaving this one blank until we get some spells, and then I'll equip a spell down here. Glodius here, he equips two-handed swords and shields, or spells. You can also equip accessories, which I'll give Noctis here the bronze bangle to boost his health a little bit. This dude, Ignis, I almost forgot his name, he does daggers and, what's the other one? Pole arms, yeah. And this dude does guns and machinery, which are like crossbows and various other types of heavy arms. And you can also change their clothing, so you can give them like casual outfit, fatigues, no jacket. We're just going to stick with the regular default stuff for now. And yeah, let's get on it. We can go kill those varmints. But first, I want to check out the diner. So let's go check out the diner. Come on, boys.
After his son's accident, I never imagined the old man to keep him.
Check out the bounties. Kenny and Kelly Crosay, only you can keep our nest safe.
Oh.
I love this. It's Sid, Cindy, and the guy we're about to talk to. We can also check on this the splats jelly.
Looks perfectly all natural from where I stand.
Not in that color, doesn't.
If you're hankering to see the disc, you can't.
All right, sup, bro?
Welcome.
And so here, every town kind of has a person like this. You can take bounties, you can eat, or you can just talk to him. This is the tipster.
What do y'all want to know?
And so this will just show us nearby havens that we can camp at. Parking spots where we can park the car. New outposts. And then other things like treasure and various things like that. And then we can eat.
Y'all say anything you
can't like. Really afford any food right now. I mean, we can sort of afford it. We can afford this chili con carne for 50 gil. Maybe we'll eat some chili con carne. And then we can also take hunting quests.
Take your pick.
We'll take this Howling Wind of Hunger quest. You can only take one hunting quest at a time. So, yeah. I mean, we could try to take another one, but it'll cancel our current one.
Bet you youngins got an appetite.
Yes, sir, we do. Chili con carne, let's do it.
You got it.
Look out, stomach.
That looks really good. The food in the game looks excellent. Like, it looks so good. Cool. So that'll give us a little boost. Ignis concocted a new recipe. Now Ignis can make chili con carne, probably. Each character also has a special, like, talent or a skill. So, let's look at them. Let's look at the skills. Yep. So, Noctis can catch fish, which you can use to cook and stuff. Glodius has survival skills. Ignis does cooking. And Prompto takes pictures. That is as useful as it sounds, but also kind of entertaining, so I'm not complaining too much about that. Let's see what quests we have. We have these two quests. They're both in pretty similar spots. Let's go do this side quest real quick. This hunt.
Want to go check it out?
What is it?
Check what out, bro? Oh. Taka's pit stop.
I wonder what sort of meat they use here.
Doesn't matter, as long as it tastes good.
Running low.
I agree with Noctis. Doesn't matter, as long as it tastes good. And it's not dog. I will not eat dog. Or cat. I will not eat domestic animals.
Gladio, come on.
But other than that, I'm pretty open. Alright, so we're going to get into some combat soon. You can swap weapons using the D-pad, as you can see here. Probably just going to stick with the short sword. Combat's pretty simple. You basically hold the circle button down, and you kind of auto-attack, and you can choose directions based, you know, you can choose directions while you're attacking to attack away or attack to the side. You can dodge, you can parry, you can, I don't know, it's pretty easy. It's not too bad. Combat's actually a lot of fun. And you can also warp to safe places and warp strike enemies. Like, I'm just gonna jump right in. So let's do it. And then Noctis can hold a certain button down and just auto dodge all the stuff. So this is a pretty tough encounter early on because it's level 2, we're only level 1. But honestly, not too bad. You can tell your buddies to do certain moves, like, yo bro, do Tempest. And then after he does it, you can press a button so you can, like, combo in with him. It's a lot of fun. It's a lot more fun than other Final Fantasy combat systems I've played. Easy peasy.
I'll give you that.
Cool, that was pretty easy. Let's take a look at our map and see if there's anything in the region we can get. I mean, there's a campground. There's some food spots. We can get some green peas. Some Lucian tomatoes. Actually, I think we need these Lucian tomatoes later. So let's go get to the green peas and the tomatoes. You really don't want to stay out too long. If you ever play Dragon's Dogma, it's similar to that. When darkness falls, a lot of enemies come out. Like, a lot of enemies come out. And that kind of brings me to my first, like, I wouldn't say major complaint of the game. Well, actually, no, this is a major complaint. There's two complaints, right? They're the load times, which take for fucking ever. You guys won't experience them because, you know, I'm cutting them all out.
On your left.
But thanks. Also, at some point, enemies will start coming out of dropships. And I don't think I want to go in that ravine yet. So I'm gonna go over here and get these potatoes or whatever, or tomatoes. Anyway, enemies will come out of dropships, and I had a level like, so my character's like level 7 or whatever, and a level 6 quest to go get these these things. It was like some ore, and level 16 dudes started pouring out of these dropships, and it wasn't like one level 16 dude. It was like 10 or more level 16 guys. It was absurd. And I, you know, stuck through it. I actually won the fight. I killed them. But immediately after that, another dropship came that had, like, more level 16 guys. And this is for, like, a level 6 quest. Like, it was absurd. So I just gave up. I was like, fuck it, I'm not doing that quest. So, yeah. So maybe that needs to be balanced. Maybe it has, like, story reasons. Maybe it's because I didn't do the story mission in that area yet, but I don't know. That was super annoying.
Bring on the next one.
Let's get these tomatoes. I think I'll need these actually later for a quest, so they're getting pretty good to get them. Cool. Is that it? Yeah. Okay, let's head back. I'll turn this quest in, and then we can start on the main quest. In case you're wondering, I will be keeping these videos around 30 minutes, like normal, you know. If you're a frequenter of my channel, 30 minutes is the average time I like to keep them.
Sometimes I wonder if I'll ever sit inside that beautiful car again.
Sitting most of the day was pretty nice.
Napping was even better.
I also agree with the sentiments here. You can see him kind of like sneaking around. It's because there's enemies down in that ravine, down in that ditch. If I remember right, there's like bird type enemies down there. Don't really want to deal with them right now. Level 2, we can take them. Yeah, I know how to warp strike.
Right there.
Let me just do it.
Warp strike to catch him off guard.
Let's swap to a different weapon.
Let's be done with this riff round.
Yeah. Line side.
What can I say?
Different weapons, so different enemies will have different resistances to different types of weapons. And you can like, yo.
This sounds like you're having fun.
Prompto, you want to calm down a little bit? Anyway, different enemies will have different weaknesses to various things. So one enemy might be resistant to like long swords, and he also might be weak to poles. It, you know, just as an example, and that's true for magic spells and things like that as well. It's pretty easy to get your head around if you've played any RPG before at all, or even like, I guess Pokemon is technically kind of an RPG. So yeah, think of it like resistances and super effectiveness in Pokemon.
Let's hit up the shop.
Sounds reasonable enough.
All right, let's see. No, I overshot it.
Are you joining us?
What? Joining you where? I'm just turning this in. Don't worry. Don't worry, guys.
Sid's friends, was it? No surprises.
Howling Wind of Hunger. Thank you, sir.
I was about a bite to eat.
We'll pick up the next quest while we're at it.
These here have been a real pain in the rear.
I'm not going to be able to do this quest for a little bit, but might as well grab it while we're here.
Take care.
All right, later, man. Alrighty. Let's see, how are we doing for time? We still got a couple minutes. So let's head over to our main objective. We may have to make camp soon, but that's fine.
Looks like we found our first targets. Ready, Nox?
Get him. If that block thing appears, then you should probably hold block.
Watch the enemy's movements.
There we go. Sweet, got like a team strike.
Allow me.
Easy peasy. You know, with that said, let's swap our quest, because I think it auto put it to varmints. What was this? Check.
What happened here?
A telegraph pole's been split in two, and not just this one either.
The hell do you think did this?
Hard to say. Natural disaster, perhaps?
You sure? A hammerhead doesn't have a scratch on it.
Maybe a huge monster came and knocked him down.
It better not be the varmint Cindy was talking about.
Giant, huge varmints. Nah, she's talking about those, like, scorpion things. More or less. Also, you can't just run forever in this game. Noctis will get tired, which is kind of annoying. I'm not a huge fan of games where they just have the arbitrary, like, stamina meter. I get it if you're in combat or something, but just all the time, it's a little annoying. It's not a, you know, not a big deal, though. Like, not a big deal at all.
Eyes peeled, mouth closed.
Whoops.
Right,
I'm warping out. Get me, bro. Oh, shit. He's got the sneaky Pete. So the way, like, knocking characters out and stuff in the game works, it's pretty simple. If one of your characters gets knocked down, you can approach them and, like, heal them, like, pick them up. And they'll have, like, a penalty to their maximum health for the duration of, basically, until you heal with a, you know, specific item or rest. And they can only be knocked down so many times before they're, like, just straight up dead. So, yeah, it's not too bad. It seems fairly forgiving in that regards, as long as level, you know, 16 guys don't pop down when you're level 5.
After that, we hop a boat, and before you know it, lover boy's hitched.
Wait for car repairs, then wedding bells in the air. Got it.
Yep, that's the plan. Car repairs and wedding bells.
Almost there. Give it your all.
I get wrecked, fools.
The Prince of Pain.
So, yeah, the combat's a lot of fun. I find myself just wanting to go back playing more of this game. I wanted to make a series sooner, but I just kept playing it. During my free time, I was like, you know what? I just want to play some more Final Fantasy. And instead of recording, I just like I want to play a little bit more, see where the story's going. Yeah, it's interesting. I like it. I like it a lot. I did watch the Kingsglaive movie before playing the game that came with the deluxe edition. The movie's all right. It's pretty good. But it kind of spoils a bit of what's going to happen in the game.
Who could this be? Hello?
Hey, it's Cindy. How goes the hunting?
Actually, we just finished.
That's great, because I got one more hunt for y'all. Only this time, it's for a person. Fella named Dave went off, and we ain't heard from him since. Reckon he staked out a spot in an old shack nearby.
Old shack? Oh, got it. We'll take a look.
Alright, guys, I think this is a good time to stop.
So, what did Cindy say? Needs us to find some Dave guy.
He went missing?
Not missing. Said he's holed up in that shack.
Alright. Yeah. Next time we'll investigate the shack. I hope you guys liked the video. I hope you guys liked the new series. I will be playing this a lot. And if people like the series, I will just continue doing it until we finish the game. It's been quite a while since I've liked a game this much. I'm having a lot of fun with it. Anyway, maybe leave a like, maybe even subscribe if you have not already. Regardless of what you do, thank you very much for watching. And I hope to see you guys next time for some more Final Fantasy XV. All right, later, guys.